Good morning, everybody. 28th. Look at it, really foggy today. So 28th September. David's down there. He's coming with me. He's starting at that well part there, and we're working into each other. We're going to see what we can come up with today. All right, David's over there. We've decided to come on this land that's been rolled, and it's lovely and flat, dead easy to dig. We're not getting many signals, but I just got this one. I got a one heller. I think it's a one heller. I couldn't tell you what date it is till it's cleaned up. So we're making a start on this new land. Okay, second coin. I think it's a two heller. David's not having much luck, he's over there. But it is easy to dig. I'm enjoying this dig because I know we've done this field before, done it with David and Danny. This is where Danny found his 15 or 1400 silver hammered, big one. So there we go, two heller. I'll tell you the date when we get back. Right, well, I weren't going to film this, but I've decided to, because it might be, I don't know. It's not hammered, but it's interesting wherever it is, so I decided I'm going to film it. All right, I just wanted to see this. David's over there, and he's got himself a silver hammered, good lad. And just look at that, how that steam's rising up off that field. And it's warm, it's quite warm now. Beautiful, just beautiful sight. I'm really enjoying today. I just thought I'd share this with you. Okay, got this lot. One of them little eye things again. If you've been looking at my videos, you'll see over the past couple of months I've had two or three of these. David's had one or two. And we're still trying to establish what they might be. But they've got like pins on the back where they stick through leather or something. I don't know if they're off horse or what, if it's some type of horse brass. Please let us know if anybody else is finding stuff like this. I'm dying to know what they are. David's just over there. He's been finding bits of pottery with beautiful patterns on. And I've just found a bit myself. Look at that. I don't know if you can see the pattern on that. Don't know. Should be able to see that. Beautiful pattern on it. And it's exactly the same as David's pattern. Yeah, you can see it now because I can see it through the camera. And it's really old, this is. This is a few hundred years old, believe me, if not a thousand or more. Stunning. So this is very old land, very old land here. Just thought you'd be interested in seeing that. Okay, it's turned into absolutely beautiful day. It's not a breath of wind. It's perfect for metal detecting. Anyway, I just got this nice signal here, and look, it's just a piece of metal. But I've got to put this down to show you something, so I'll put it down on there, and you can see there's a curvature on there. So whatever this was round, and it's brass or bronze, that is very thin. I don't know what it could be, I don't know how old it might be, but it's just, everything has got a story, everything's interesting. What about, right, David just walked over. I'm not going to show you what he's got, because as he was walking over, I got a signal. And I've just dug that out of the ground. It's bronze, because it's all bronzy green. And then David says, look what I found. And he hands me this. Look at that. I'm going to show you that. Let me come this side. Look. That's beautiful, isn't it? Right, now my phone's going. And look, mine's almost the same. Look at that. Anyway, I'm going to answer this phone. Well, I've just had two really good signals. One there, right behind me, look. A cracking signal, shotgun cartridge. I step 1 meter, get another cracking signal, and it's this lot, a bronze nut. I don't know. This ground's been gone over before, but we're all finding odd bits and pieces. David's found a silver hammer, so there's probably more here. So we're going to keep going. It's a beautiful day. All right, just found this four-hole button. Not getting many signals now, although this land has been done before. But I think this is a military underwear button, German uniform probably. They look very, very similar to this, but if it is, it's in really good condition. I don't know what this is. Turn that off. I don't know what it is, but there's a pattern on it. There's something on it. And I can't make out what it is. I don't know if it's a guy standing up. Or whatever, but it's interesting, that is, and it's bloody old, I reckon. I won't know until we get it back and clean it up, but it's not a coin, because look, it's got like something on the back, like where it could have been a button, I don't know, but there's something special about this. I'm interested in it, so we'll let you know when we get back. Right, so what's that? Is that a bent spoon handle or what? I don't know, could be, but it's bronze anyway. Okay, just found this really interesting. Looks like a little capstan, look. But it's bronze. And you can see it's like a teardrop shape from the bottom. And that's what it looks like from the top. Got no idea what it might be for. It's decorated around the top there. I don't know. And it's hollow in the top, look. So I don't know. I don't have a clue. It's not a drawer handle, is it? I don't know, for something interesting. Just found this cool bag seal, got a lovely pattern on it, I don't know if you can see that. Lovely, lead bag seal. Okay, this was the next thing to come up. Don't know what it is, I think it's a button. I'm not sure, there's no shank on the back, but maybe this was the top of the button, I don't know. But it's not a coin, I'm pretty sure it's not a coin. Okay, so that's it for the day, it's 3 o'clock now. David's in the car there. We moved off here after I found that coin or whatever it is. We moved off here, so we're up to about here somewhere, marked it with stones, look. So there's stones there, and that's where I start next time, because there might be more coins on here. But we left it after that and we went up there, and David found a silver hammer, but there's nothing else here much. He found that silver hammer. And we both found nothing but crap all day long then. So we're going to come back here, but David can't come for a week or 10 days now. So we're going to leave it for a week or 10 days. And then we're going to come back, start at these stones here, and finish off this field.
Being beat up and battered around, been sent up and I've been shot down. You're the best thing that I've ever found. Handle me with care. Reputation's changeable, situation's terrible. But baby, you're adorable. Handle me with care. Your body next to mine.